So already I told in this fifth module you are going to study transaction processing, concurrency control and recovery technique. Already we have seen the transaction processing concepts. Now we are going to see the concurrency control technique in DBMS. So especially in this class we are going to discuss about two-phase logging technique for concurrency control. So first we will see what is the purpose of concurrency control. So first purpose is to ensure that the isolation property is maintained while allowing transaction to execute concurrently. That is the first one. Next, to preserve database consistency. Why the database consistency should be preserved means by ensuring the schedules of executing transactions are serializable. To resolve read-write and write-write conflicts among transactions. So this is the purpose of concurrency control. Okay, especially that ACID properties are there, no? In that it has to satisfy the second and third property, CI, isolation and consistency property, to preserve that, and as well as resolve read-write conflicts and write-write conflicts. So the two-phase locking techniques for concurrency control we are using. So here we are going to use lock, L-O-C-K. Lock, we can think about our door lock, our system lock, we are using everything. Like that, it is a variable associated with the data item describing the status for operations that can be applied. One lock for each item in the database. Okay. So there are different types of locks, and the first one is binary locks. Next we are going to see shared or exclusive locks and so on. The binary locks, from the name itself it is there. There will be a two states in that thing. The locks, that is, one is locked state, another one is unlocked state. Locked state means it will take the binary value 1, that is, it returns a value true. Unlocked state means it takes the binary value 0, that is, return as false. If that is locked of 1, it means the lock, it is having the value 1, means the corresponding item cannot be accessed. It is locked. Unlocked of 0 means the item can be accessed when requested, because it is unlocked. When it is, any request is there, it can be accessed. Then binary locks, we know two operations should be performed over here. Lock and unlock item are used for binary operations locking. So that is, transaction requests access to an item X by first issuing lock item of X operation. See here. So in the binary lock, first the lock item of X of that should be there. If lock of X is equal to 0 means that indicates the system is unlocked. Unlocked means it will be set to 1 to lock it. Otherwise, until the lock of X is equal to 0, that lock manager has to wake up the transaction. It has to wait. Unlock item of X. Then lock x of equal to 0. That means that unlock the item. Then if any transactions are waiting, then wake up one of the waiting transactions to read the value, can read it. Once it is unlocked means. Locked means until it will lock, that transaction has to wait. Okay. So there will be a lock table. Each log can be recorded with three fields, that is data item, name, lock, locked or unlocked, and locking transaction, which transaction should be performed, read or write, plus queue for transaction that are waiting to access the item, that will be there. The system needs to maintain only these records for the items that are currently locked in a lock table. This one only it is going to maintain. Especially the hash table representation is used to represent the lock table, because here the frequent operation is performed as, only thing is appending the data, the information about the transaction, the log, the details. So the hash table representation is used. So for the simple binary locking scheme, how it works means, a transaction T must issue the operation lock item of X before any read of item of x or write item of x are performed in it. Okay, a transaction T must issue the operation unlock item of x after all read item of x or read item of x operations are completed in it. Transaction T will not issue a lock item of x operation if it already holds the lock. Transaction T will not issue an unlock item of x operation unless it already holds the lock and item x. It is locked means that unlock can be done. Otherwise, no need. If you are issuing lock item of x, already it is locked means no need for that. Not issue this one. Okay. So, these things we should keep it in mind. So, what is the drawback of binary lock means? At most, one transaction can hold the lock on an item at a given time. There are multiple transactions, at least one transaction will hold the lock. Binary locking too restrictive for database items. These are the drawbacks. To overcome the drawback, we are going for shared or exclusive locks. That is otherwise called as read or write locks. So in binary locks, what is the drawback? Only one transaction can hold a lock at a time. But here, problem is rectified. Transaction overcome this drawback by shared or exclusive locks. Here two locks are needed. One is shared lock, another read lock, and another one is exclusive lock. Shared lock is read lock. That means multiple transactions can use that lock to read the value. Only for exclusive lock, there is a write lock. So that should be used with the help of permission. Okay, read lock of x, several transactions can hold the shared lock of x because read operations are not conflicting, not changing the data stored in the database. Exclusive mode means write lock of x. Only write lock on x can exist at any time on item x. Okay, no read or write locks on x by other transactions can exist. So this is the algorithm like previously we have seen a binary lock. Same thing, we have to go through read lock of x. If lock of x is equal to unlocked means we have to check whether read locked or not. That we have to check it. So here we have that lock conversion, upgrading and downgrading. Lock conversion means transaction that already holds the lock allowed to convert the lock from one state to another state. Upgrading means issue a read lock operation, then a write lock operation. Downgrading means issue a read write operation after a write lock operation. Read to write means it is upgrading. Write to read means it is a downgrading. So in the two phase locking protocol, there are two phases, that is expanding phase and shrinking phase. Expanding phase means new locks can be acquired but none can be released. Expanding because with the help of new locks but nothing can be released. So here lock conversion upgrades must be done during this phase. But during shrinking phase, what will happen? No? Existing locks can be released but none can be acquired. Downgrades must be done during this phase. Okay, this is the techniques. Two-phase locking technique. So here we will take T1 and T2. So first T1 will take this operation. So first the serial schedule, that is followed by T1 followed by T2 means T1 re-performs read Y, write Y, read Y, read lock, read Y, then unlock Y. Then write lock, read item x. Then x is equal to x plus 10 means x is equal to x plus y means x is equal to 20, y equal to 30, then x is equal to 50. Then it will write the value 50. Unlock x, that will be unlocked. Then T2 is performed means read lock x, read item of x, unlock x, write lock of x, read item of y. Then y equal to x plus y means that y value is already, it is written as 30, and x value is already it is 50. So 30 x value is